Dhoni, for whatever his heroics in the last over, is not firing normally the way that he should. And that's something that I'm not saying that he's not done the best he can under the circumstances, but he's not the Dhoni of old. There's something still missing there. He's missing something right now, and India is missing it so as well. We might still make it through. We might still have more than enough on the board, but I think we've not seen the Dhoni that we are used to seeing.
Well, interesting point, interesting opposing point to what we were expecting to hear, to be honest, because at least personally, I felt he was absolutely phenomenal under the circumstances. Yes, started slowly, but Virat Kohli gone, one extra batsman less in a sense with Mohammad Shami at 8 instead of Bhuvaneshwar Kumar. Let's have a look at the follow wickets, and I'll get the experts back in there and see why there was an area of concern for India. Little similarity to the Afghanistan game with Virat Kohli being the lone ranger, batted beautifully, but once he got out, there was obviously concern for India. We're showing you on the left follow wickets against Afghanistan, and on the right, 38th over, 180 for 5, with Hardik Pandya knowing that he's not going to be maybe the same Hardik Pandya if he has insurance at the back end.
See, at the you have to consider, as in this, I think, is a little bit of over analysis, but I think if you stay in the present and just look at the situation that India find themselves in, and the 28.5 over, they lost their fourth wicket at 140, and we all knew as after the first 15 overs that this is not going to be a 300 score, or maybe not. If we get to 300, it'll be a brilliant score. It's not a 330, 340 wicket because of the wicket and the conditions. The ground is very big. They're bowling well, so with all due credit, with everywhere that needs to be given, you knew that 300 was like your par score or slightly above par score. And he came in at number 6 with one batsman behind him to follow. That's Hardik Pandya, and that is your main batsman who can hit a 6 from the first ball. So that is a consideration that we have to keep. Now that he's come to bat at number 6, at that point he cannot bat at his normal pace. Now if he had come to bat at number 4, you could be sure that at least 95% of the time Dhoni does not get out in the first, like if he doesn't get out in the first 15-20 balls, and if he does, that's 5% of the times. But when he doesn't, you know that he's going to stay, hold one end up. I think that is probably where India need to make a shift, use his experience and use the fact that he can hold one end up for you to actually use him at number 4, so that there's more cushion when you're going into the last 15 overs of this one day game. So for me, that's what I feel India should do. But given the situation, I thought he batted really well. India couldn't afford to lose any more wickets. India couldn't afford to take any more chances, because if he went there and played like we all normally know Dhoni to play, and if that didn't come off and he got out, because if you saw him after he stepped out and that missed thumping happened, he decided that, you know, he's just going to hold one end up. You could see that in the way he exuded his energy there when he was batting. You saw that, okay, let me just hold one end up. After Virat got out, he still had the same mindset. He said, even more, let me just bat till the last 3 overs because I only have Hardik now. Now, with Hardik, he said, Hardik, you play. You could see that he gave Hardik the freedom to say, you play your shots, I'll hold one end up for the team. Hardik came off. They ran beautifully between the wickets, and that goes amiss in a partnership like this, and that is why we got a 268. Now, if he had gone on the offensive from the get go,
could have been 240.
It could have been 235.
No, absolutely. I don't at all debate that when he played what he did substantially, but I'll give you one simple stat. So there's something called true run rate. True run rate means, what is my run rate versus my team's run rate? That means if my team scores 300, my team's run rate is 6. What is my run rate versus my team's run rate? And in this tournament, okay, before the last, this thing was started, before the last over started, he was one run behind the team's average run rate. That means Dhoni was scoring at one run an average, over average, less than the rest. He's probably made up a bit. He'd probably be 0.7, 0.8. My worry is not that. My worry is not, I don't think that Dhoni is not playing the situation of the team. Dhoni is, as you said, probably the greatest batsman in terms of playing the situation. But are we playing him in the right place?
Yeah.
Are we playing him in a situation where he can play with any freedom?
I think that's the most pertinent question that should be asked. Is he being played at the position that is most useful and productive for India? I don't think number 6 is going to be the most useful and productive for India because of what's happening at that middle order. Now, past Dhoni, you need someone solid to come in. Because in case Dhoni gets out early, then you have an... Like if India is 10 for 2 and then a Vijay Shankar comes, a lot of them in the dressing room are feeling a lot more insecure, with all due respect to Vijay, a lot more, like, because of his experience at number 4. If he had played 30 games at number 4 and he had done well for himself, nobody would question it. But you know the caliber of Dhoni. You know what he brings to the table. Dhoni has only in his entire career played situations. He's never gone there and played in his own role. He's gone and played situations. You take any game Dhoni plays, he plays the situation. He plays the bowler, the conditions, the situation. He doesn't play anything else. So for me, I think if he comes at number 4, you sort out a lot of issues.